Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with our Vue Skeleton component. A skeleton screen is a visual placeholder that appears before the page content renders completely, to give the impression of a faster load time. In this video, I am going to explain how to add the Vue Skeleton component to a Vue application, and how to customize the component using the shape, effect, and CSS class options. Let me start with the application creation process. I'm going to create a Vue application using the Vue CLI toolchain. Edit my code in Visual Studio Code, and finally, view the output on a supported browser. To install Vue CLI globally, I open Visual Studio Code and type the command npm install global Vue CLI. As I have done the installation already, I am skipping this step now. Then, I create a new project using the Vue create command and provide the app name, My Vue Project. I navigate to the newly created Vue app. To use the Syncfusion Vue Skeleton component, let me install the Syncfusion Vue Notifications package using the command npm install syncfusion/ej2vue-notifications --save. This command will install the Vue Notifications package along with its dependencies. Once the installation is completed, my application is ready to use. The first thing I need to do here is register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. So, I open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. From the 2022 Volume 1 release, it is required to register the Vue license key. To know how to generate this license key, refer to the link attached in the description below. Now, the application is configured to use Syncfusion Vue components. Look at this image. Here is a card layout with images and text. It has a profile picture, profile name, and post content in it. I am going to show you how to display the skeleton layout for this card content. For that, first I need to design the card. So, let me open the app.vue page and remove the default code on this page. As I am going to use the Syncfusion Vue card for designing the layout, I install the Syncfusion Vue layouts package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2vue-layouts --save. To design the card, I add an HTML division element first. To this division element, I add the class attribute and set the predefined class, eCard, to it. This eCard class will add default style attributes to the outer layout of the card UI. Next, I add the content of this card by copying the code snippet from an existing demo. Here, I have added an HTML table to place the image and label elements. This image tag will display the profile picture and this label element will display the profile name. Finally, I added another image tag in a separate division element for displaying the post picture. I have also added class attributes to these HTML elements and defined them inside the style tag for better alignment of the content inside the card. To view this card in the browser, I run the application using the npm run serve command. Here, the card layout is rendered with the defined content. Now, I will show you how to display the skeleton layout for this card content. Later, I will illustrate the real purpose of using the skeleton layout in the application by showing it as a loading indicator before the actual content of the card loads. Okay, to render the skeleton layout of this card, I will replace every element in this card with the appropriate skeleton. To start using the skeleton component, import it from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Notifications package. And register it globally inside the component's property with all its child directives. Now, to replace the profile picture with the appropriate skeleton, I comment out the image tag used for the profile picture in the card. And add the EJS skeleton tag. To this skeleton tag, I need to define the height and width properties. I set the height to 35 pixels. And the width to 100 pixels. Look at the output page now, the profile picture is replaced with the skeleton. The skeleton is rendered in its default shape variant, text. I would like to change the shape of this profile picture skeleton to a circle. To do this, I use the shape property. The Syncfusion Vue Skeleton component supports a total of 4 shape variants like text, circle, square, and rectangle. To display a circle skeleton, I set the shape property to circle. For a circle, it is enough to set just the width dimension, so I remove the height property. And change the width value to 60 pixels. Check now, the profile picture is replaced by a circle-shaped skeleton. Similarly, I will replace the rest of the card elements with the skeleton components. First, I comment out the label element. And add the EJS skeleton tag. As I am displaying a skeleton for the label element, I set the shape property to text. For text and rectangle shapes, I need to define height and width dimensions. So, I set the height to 15 pixels. And the width to 200 pixels. Next, I comment out this image tag. As the post content image is in a rectangle shape, I will display a rectangle-shaped skeleton here. So, I add an EJS skeleton tag with a rectangle shape. And then I set the height to 250 pixels. And the width to 375 pixels. Looking at the output page now, the card is displayed with skeletons for all its content elements. As I said before, now I am going to tell you how these skeletons work as loading indicators, before the actual content of the card loads. To demonstrate this, I am going to set a delay of 5 seconds to render the card, and during that delay time, I will display the skeleton layout of the card. For that, I declare the Boolean variable isDataLoaded. Next, I define a method called loadData. And within it, I set a delay of 5 seconds using the setTimeout method. Then I set the isDataLoaded variable to true. As a next step, I override the mounted method. And make a call to this loadData method. This mounted method is an inbuilt view method, triggered during the first render of the view component. Next, I will check if the isDataLoaded variable is true inside the template section. And display the actual content of the card within it. Otherwise, I will display the skeleton. I repeat the same for other skeletons too. You will see the skeletons display as loading indicators for about 5 seconds in the output page and disappear as the content of the card loads. Next, I will show you how to customize the look of the skeleton component by changing its background image and color using the CSS class property. To demonstrate, I set the CSS class property to e-customize. I repeat the same for other skeletons too. Within the style tag, I define this e-customize class and append the component base classes like e-skeleton and e-shimmerwave. Then, I set the custom background color and background image for the component. Looking at the output page, the skeleton components are displayed with a customized background image and color. Next, I'll show you how to apply animation effects to the skeleton component. As I demonstrated earlier, the default animation effect is wave. But the component also supports other effects like pulse, fade, and none. I'll show you how to apply the pulse effect to the skeleton now. I define the shimmer effect property and set the value to pulse. Then, I repeat the same for other skeleton components to apply the same pulse animation effect to them. See the output page now. The skeletons are rendered with the pulse animation effect. In this video, I showed you how to create a Vue application and add the Vue skeleton component to it. You also saw how to customize the skeleton component using the shape, effects, and CSS class options. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Vue products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.